Okay guys, I want you to say something that is really important. That is, hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. If you're new to this channel and you want to know what this channel is about, basically I'm an expat in France and I want to share my experience and I want to help you guys as well with some tips if you're thinking to move abroad. As well, I will show you around some places that I visit here in France. I want to show you how is the lifestyle, and basically Avec Inés is all about this experience. So if you're interested about, just subscribe so you don't miss any of my new videos. So today guys, what I bring you is a video where I gather some platforms where you can find work abroad. I know really well how overwhelming can be the beginning when you're starting to think that you want to go abroad, but where should I look for jobs, openings, which countries should I choose? There are a bunch of variables that it may make you feel overwhelmed. I don't know if you know, but I'm living in France for more than 1 year. And as well, I passed through this process, so don't worry, because I will share with you all my tips. I got your back. Without further ado, let's jump to the video. There are two main reasons why people go overseas. One is either because they want to have a short time experience, like a gap year, and the other one is because you want to evolve your career and just have an experience abroad that will really make you have a more open-minded on the business context. So the video of today is really to focus on this career path that you want to do abroad, but I will do a dedicated video where you can find some platforms, where you can find opportunities for a gap year, so stay tuned so you don't miss it. I have a couple of platforms where you can find a job abroad, and the number one that I will speak about is LinkedIn. LinkedIn is becoming a I would say that it must be the most worldwide known network platform where you can find easily jobs and where recruiters are. I just ask you please not do the same mistake that I did, that I just start to work on my LinkedIn network once I decided that I wanted to go abroad. No, actually I'm lying. I just created my LinkedIn profile once I decided to go abroad. In order to be successful on your search for a job, you need already to have a strong LinkedIn profile. And what does it mean, a strong LinkedIn profile? You have to have a considerable network, meaning connections. You should have some recommendation by your current colleagues, and you should have a well-detailed profile. On my case, I didn't have that many connections because I was just starting, and I didn't have any recommendations by colleagues or even university, because once again, I just had created a profile. So this LinkedIn philosophy should be even like work in, I will not say daily, but in a constant way. Even if you're not looking for a job currently, you should work in your LinkedIn network. I mean, you know it, social media is ruling the world, so you should be on social media even to find work nowadays. The benefit of LinkedIn is that you can select all the countries, you can filter job openings, and you will receive also notifications when you have new job openings that are related with the topics that you search by. I would say this is the main platform, so definitely go check it, and if you still don't have a profile, just create one. For my case, I was not recruited by LinkedIn, but as well, there's another platform that is well known. I mean, I don't know if it's that well known, but it works really well. I have as well other colleagues that subscribed on this platform, and they were contacted by recruited agencies like this. So it's monster.com, and basically as well, you create your profile and you will write, if I remember correctly, you write your profile, you write your preference, you can attach your own CV, and that will work like a search engine, if I remember correctly, and people will find you. And I think there are no, the concept of connections there, at least I was not connected, or I didn't have like links with anybody else, but that was found out by recruiters. And definitely go check it, and it's another really good platform. I mean, at least I think it's really responsive in the sense that you gain, you will be contacted in a really short period if your CV matches the needs of the recruiters. So another online platform that you can have access is called ERES, and this platform is really dedicated for the European Union. And they have a really cool program that is, if you're between 18 and 35 years old, they have something that they call the My First ERES Job. And why they are this is so cool is because if you get hired through this platform, what ERES program will provide you will be some financial support when you will move to the new country. This financial support is proportional to the kilometers that you will be away from your hometown. What does it mean? It means that the more far away you will be from your hometown, the biggest will be this financial support. What is really cool, because when you move abroad, all the help is well received. But this is not the only thing that they provide. They also will provide help with the language course. That is really amazing. Okay, we know that English it's really a well-known language, but nevertheless, you most probably will always need to learn the language of the country that you're moving in, and this is really cool. So they also provide this support, but just as a side note, this, as I said, the program is My First ERES Job. So they will just provide this support if you're under 18 and 35 years old, and if it's your first job through this mobility program. So on the ERES program, what you will need to do is upload your curriculum profile, and you will need to subscribe under this program, and then you will have as well another database with the companies where they will put their job postings. So you will see frequently job postings and you can apply directly to them. So go definitely check it out, the platform. Another well-known online platform is Indeed. And this platform, I think that is really well known across countries. And basically here you don't really need to upload your CV. It's just you will have job openings there, and you can you will have like a hyperlink that will redirect you to the job posting that can be directly redirect to the main, to the company itself. And it can be really nice as well, because you have a lot of job postings there for all types of jobs. But I really think it's not as easy to use or helpful to use, because in the end it will be you that will need to do all the work of searching, while in LinkedIn, the LinkedIn itself will propose you some job openings, as well you will have recruiters on the other side that can do by themselves as well the research and find your profile. That as well happens in Monsters, and in ERES as well is like a facilitator between the parts. Well, Indeed it's not like that. In the end, I find it Indeed like almost like Google. You will have a bunch of results, and then you will need to filter out, and you will need to do to select the criteria that match your expectations. So another platform that is similar to Indeed but is more for the UK, it's read.co.uk. Then there's another platform that this was a colleague of mine that gave me as a reference for the Germany working marketplace, that is Xing. This is really popular there. According to him, it's more popular even than LinkedIn. So if you're thinking to go to Germany, it may be really a good option for you. And I really think this is a really nice tip, because I didn't know that in Germany LinkedIn was not as famous as in the rest of the other countries, at least here in Europe. So go check it out if you're thinking to move to Germany. Okay guys, so far I just give online platforms, but please, I want you to say something that is really important, that is, reference schemes as well are really, really important. When you're thinking to move abroad, please speak with your colleagues that are already abroad, ask them how it is. There are companies that promote inside their network and incentivize their employees to do referral schemes. What does it mean is that, imagine me, my company, if I have some colleague that matches the profile that my company wants to propose a CV, and they will analyze it, and if they match the profile that they are searching for, they will either call him if they already have a vacancy, or perhaps they will store it, but when the need will come, they will call him and propose him for perhaps an interview. So this is really important. Speak with colleagues, and moreover, not just for the referral scheme, but for instance, in my case, when I was thinking, initially I was even thinking to move to England. I was speaking to everyone that I knew that was in England. If your dream is to move abroad and to have this amazing experience, please just talk to everybody that you know that is outside, try to understand what is happening, what is needed, where can you find a job, and it may be really, they may open a door for you, and please just speak out with your colleagues and friends. So guys, I really hope that you liked this video. If you liked this video, give me a like. Share with people that may be interested by this video, and I really hope that it was helpful for you guys. Let me know if you want me to do more videos related to this topic. Share your feedback, let me a comment below, let me know if you have some queries. As well, I want to say you guys that for me it has been an amazing experience, and if you're really motivated to go abroad, I know that it can be a bit scary in the beginning with everything that you need to do, but if it's your dream, you should do it. You should always pursue what you really want to do. I mean, I always knew that I wanted to do an experience abroad when I was younger. I knew that I really wanted to do an Erasmus program. I was not able to do it, but once I started to work, I said no, now it's the time, and I took the courage to move abroad alone, and I really hope that this video can inspire you to do it as well. Guys, really, if you feel that it's something that you really want to do, you should take the opportunity to do it. My mom was all the time telling me, what is the worst that can happen? If it does not go well, you just come back home. So, really, if it's really something that you want to do, that you're passionate about, to get to know new culture, different people, just take the risk. Let me know your feedback about this video, and I hope this was really helpful for you guys. Don't forget to follow me as well on Instagram, so you don't lose nothing of this adventure. And I'll see you next Sunday, guys. Ciao!